Okay, and we are back. So this time for the ongoing series of extremely high production value recordings on the player. I'm just showing you my very fancy setup here with the OBS as the recording system, and I'm really on top of all of it. So I'll quickly hide that and make it look like this is very classy and done the way that it's supposed to be. I actually can't see my face when I'm doing this, so I have no idea what I look like, and I am so sorry. Okay, so we are up to data arranging. Now, at the end of the last recording, I asked you to put together, I had put together a data frame that contained all of the forward associations to the word woman, and now what we're going to do is what I asked you to do in the exercise was to put together one with all the backwards associations. So let's just quickly get me caught up to where hopefully you are, and I will go. Okay, so what we need to do is something very similar to what we did. So I'm just going to copy and paste. But this is essentially the exact same code. All I need to do is, firstly, if I'm going to create the backwards associations, I'd better edit this variable so that it's now going to be called woman BCK. And remember, backwards associations are those in which the response variable equals the backwards associates to woman are those where people respond with woman rather than the responses people gave when cued with woman. So if we go response equals woman, we save that. I'm going to go Control Shift S to source. This is my keyboard shortcut, which is super handy for making my life a little bit easier. As you can see, I've restarted my R session in between these recordings, so it's doing all that again. Let's just clear all of that rubbish away. So this is what we had, if you remember, for woman forward. So the forward associations were, there were only 8 of them that reached the threshold, which makes sense, right? We asked 100 people to give us an answer when we cued them with the word woman. And so since 38 people said man and 22 people said female, there's not a lot of scope left for there to be lots and lots of possible forward associates, right? Backwards associates are different. With backwards associates, I'll just make that, bring that back up here. With backwards associates, when I go woman BCK to get the backwards associates, what you can see, and I'll just highlight it here, is that we have 200 possible responses, right? There are many, many words in the English language that could have produced woman as a response. So there are actually 200 words that for which woman was produced as a response. So this is a much bigger data set than the last one. And you can see, just from looking at it, it hasn't come out in a great order. So the top response, or the top listed response, is abuse. Okay, yeah, abused woman is a thing that we talk about in real life. Domestic violence is a sadly realistic thing in the world. This is actually a nice opportunity to mention that all of the words here have been reduced to to word stems. So if the word was abusing, abuser, abuses, abuse, sieve, they've all been converted to abuse. So there's an element of pre-processing that's gone into the data in its current form. Okay, regardless, the point is that given abuse as the cue word, woman was not actually that high a response. Like, it was only produced in two of the cases. Actress, on the other hand, produces woman as 7 of the 100 responses. So actress is a stronger backwards associate of woman than abuse, but they haven't popped out in the right order. They've shown up in alphabetical order in our data set, in our output, but we would probably want to look at this in terms of order of decreasing strength. So what we're going to do is arrange or rearrange the structure of our data set, and that's what we're talking about today, or in this little recording. And once again, she forgets which thing she's doing. We are going to do some data arranging, kind of like flower arranging, except boring. So as I've pointed out, the forward associates that we got originally were neatly arranged. The Backwards associates, however, were not. So what we need to do is reorganize the backwards associates so that they appear in a different order. And the function that we're going to use to do this rearranging is, shockingly enough, called arrange. Because obviously I wouldn't have set up the whole slides like this if it was called something else. And here's how we do it. So if we just go arrange by, so arrange strength means, so what we're going to do is order all of the output by the value of the strength variable. And what we get as the output is actually not amazingly helpful. So if we look at the results here, again we've got abuse at the top with a strength of 0.02 and Amazon at 0.02 and a whole lot of other things at 0.02. The reason this is happening is that by default the arrange function organizes things in increasing order. So it's starting with the smallest and they're going up to the biggest. And we want the opposite. We would like to reorder these rows in terms of decreasing strength, so that the strongest response is at the top and the weakest response is at the bottom. For that, what we need to do is tell it to use descending order using a function called desc. Yeah, I know. So arrange desc strength, or descending order of strength, does it the other way around. So here, the strongest backwards associate of woman is man. In other words, given man as the keyword, 57 of the 99 responses that we have in the data set were woman. And so that is the strongest backwards associate of woman. The next strongest backwards associate is lady. So given the word lady as a keyword, 36 of the responses were woman. Feminist is a very strong backwards associate of woman. So given feminist as a keyword, 30 of the responses turned out to be woman. So this is how we arrange things in the order that we want. So again, there's another exercise that I will ask you to do in just a moment. But let's go and update my code so that it does the right answer. Let's just see that this works. So in my script, what I've currently got is I've got two pipelines. So the first one that starts here takes SWOW and does these filtering operations and produces the forward associates. What I want to do now is just continue these forward associates. So they continue this by adding another step in my pipeline, but I only need to do it for the backwards associates. So we'll do it here, arrange, and we do arrange by descending order of strength. And as always, we save and Control Shift S to source. It does everything again. Let me clear my screen. And from there, remembering that I actually have another keyboard I can type at, and then go woman. I'm not very good at this keyboard. Woman back is, okay, so there you go. This is the data that you saw in the slides. So the strongest backwards associate to woman is man, then lady, feminist, female, pregnant, housewife, vagina. I'm not so sure that the English language is going to turn out to be the most interesting or nicest of things, but we'll see. You know, I mean, we're not seeing anything that I would call a slur, so that's nice. I've done versions of this analysis that do pop up with slurs, and that is really, really upsetting. Okay, so thankfully, we are not. We can keep this podcast YouTube thingy. I don't know. I'm old. Shut up. I'm keeping this, PG rated, so that we're not going to get into some of the nastier parts of the data set. You have an exercise to do, and in the exercise what I want you to do is open up the dplyr3 file, create analogous data sets for man as an associate. So we're going to have man forward and man back, and make sure that all of your data sets are arranged in descending order of strength. And once again, trying to kick to my thing, I will be back in just a moment to talk about variable selection.